Good morning, students. Today, from the chapter number 3, that is forces, we are going to discuss friction. What is friction? Friction is the force that opposes or tends to oppose motion between surfaces in contact. Always remember, friction exists between surfaces, between two or more surfaces. The friction that is between the surfaces tries or it stops or tries to stop the motion. Now, what is the cause of friction? The cause of friction is microscopic surface irregularities, which means that the surfaces that are sliding over each other or moving over each other have very small irregularities at the surfaces, and these irregularities result in the friction. These irregularities get stuck in each other and this causes friction, and due to this friction the sliding surfaces get warm or get heated. As in the case when you rub your hands, the fingerprints and the prints that you have on your hands, they get stuck in each other while you are rubbing, and this causes the warming of your hand. Now, what are the effects of the friction? There are two types of effects, negative and positive effects. What are the negative effects? Negative effects include, it can reduce the power of engine up to 20%. So this results in the less efficiency of an engine. The second negative effect is, it can cause wear and tear in moving parts of machines such as motors or engines. Their parts that are moving together, these parts can be destroyed due to friction if the friction exceeds a certain level. Next comes, what are the positive effects of friction? For walking and holding things, like when I am holding this marker, if there is no friction between my fingers and the surface of the marker, this marker will slip away from my hands. So for holding things and for walking, when you walk, your the sole of your feet or your shoes, due to friction between the surface or the floor and your foot, you get the hold on the ground and you can walk. But if the ground is slippery, there is no friction and walking is not possible at the slippery ground. So this was about friction. What causes the friction and what are the effects of friction? Now, these effects include some negative effects. These negative effects can reduce our efficiency of doing things. So how can we reduce this? These negative effects. The next positive effect of friction is braking system of cars. You know that when you apply the brake, this is the tire, and when you apply the brake, let's suppose this is the brake shoe. This brake shoe gets attached with the rim of the tire, and the friction between this brake shoe and the tire stops the car. This is how braking system works. But if there is no friction between the brake shoe and the tire, the car won't stop. Now, how we can reduce the negative effects of friction, we will discuss it in our tomorrow's lecture.